It's 2 o'clock, so we'll proceed with the commission meeting for Thursday, November 7th, 2019. I will lead us in invocation, and Commissioner Stevens will lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Would you please stand? Our dear Heavenly Father, we just thank you for this day. And Father, we just ask your wisdom and understanding as we take the business of this county and all of our customers and residents of Glynn County. Father, we thank you for the opportunity we have to live in such a beautiful community. And Father, we ask for those people who've lost loved ones or have injured loved ones, that you just be with them and comfort them and just comfort those people. And in particular, Father, those people that were so critically killed down in Mexico for just some unknown reason. We don't understand certain things, God, but we know you're in control of everything. And just give us, help us to bring glory to you in everything we say and do. It's in your name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We'll move to the public comment period. We have one public comment from Ms. Monica Smith.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Yes, I'm Monica Smith, and I live on St. Simon's Island. As you know, I've been following the activities of this body for some 5 years now. And if I remember correctly, a portion of the rather large debt that you all inherited was accrued in the building of a lift station that was to serve the Colonel's Island area. So what I'm here today to ask is that perhaps you request an update on the amount of service that's being provided through that lift station to Colonel's Island, and consider particularly whether or not the new development of an additional car wash serving, taking care of 400 cars a day over on the south side of 17, is also going to be connected into the system so that that wastewater is properly treated and not discharged into our marshes or the ocean. And I, as I said, I don't expect an answer right on the spot, but I hope that at some time we can get an answer to those questions. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you for your comments, and we thank you for participating in our meetings. And we'll get with the staff and get an answer to your comments. Thank you very much. We need to go into executive session for personnel.
Going to executive session.
Second.
All in favor? We'll adjourn now for executive session.
Come out of executive session.
Second.
All in favor? Motion carries 6-0. We need to have a motion to adjourn, to amend the agenda.
Mr. Chairman, I'll make a motion that we amend the agenda to be, to reflect what is posted on the revised posting.
A second?
Second.
Motion second, all in favor? Motion carries 6-0. I also want to request that we have a motion to exempt Commissioner Stevens from the, Commissioner Copeland from the meeting. She's out of town this week. Motion second, all in favor? Motion carries 6-0. Next item on the agenda is the committee updates. Facilities Committee, I'm going to talk about the item four on the approval in a few minutes. But other than that, we'll have a facilities meeting on, at 3 o'clock on the 19th, or the 20th. Is it 20th?
20th.
On the 20th.
On the 20th. Finance Committee, Commissioner Copeland's not here. He'll be having a Finance Committee meeting that same day that starts at 1:30. Is there any other commission, committee members, committee chairman have any reports?
No, sir.
I don't have a report.
No.
Hearing none.
Next meeting is the 13th. That's right.
Yeah, the human resources. Next thing on the agenda, we move to the approval section, the minutes from the October 17th, 2019 regular meeting. I have a motion to accept those minutes.
Motion to accept the minutes on October 17th, 2019, sir, regular scheduled meeting.
Second.
Motion and a second. All in favor? Motion carries 6-0. You have in front of you the minutes from the executive session of Thursday, October 17th, 2019. I hear a motion to accept those.
Motion to accept.
Second.
All in favor? Motion passes 6-0. The next item on the agenda is Christmas gift cards for JWSC staff. Ms. Wilson.
Good afternoon, Commissioners. Again, the item before you is the Christmas gift cards. In the years past, the Commission has given gift cards to its employees as a token of appreciation and thanks. The cost of the cards are included in the fiscal year budget. So the staff recommends that the Commission give its employees the $25 gift card from Walmart. It's good at Walmart or Sam's. The total number of cards would be 155 for a cost of $3,875.
And that's in the budget, correct?
It's in the budget.
Do I hear a motion?
Mr. Chairman, I move that the Brunswick-Glynn County Joint Water and Sewer Commission provide employees with a gift card in the amount of $25 to Walmart. Total number of the cards would be 155 for a cost of $3,875.
Second.
There's a motion and a second. I have a question. When do they get those cards?
We are going to distribute them on December the 6th. It'll be the first payroll in December.
Okay, so they'll have them well before Christmas.
Yes, sir.
For the use of Christmas. Any other questions?
I have a comment. Before we actually buy them, typically when you buy them this many, they'll give you a break on the price.
No, sir, they don't.
They don't?
Unfortunately, they have it. Not in years past.
A lot of places will. Walmart might not. But.
They have it in the past. I've gotten some at Walmart, some at Sam's because they're interchangeable, and so far no one has ever given us a discount.
Let's ask for it this time.
I will.
Okay.
If you have no other questions, all in favor indicate by raising your right hand. Motion carries 6-0.
Thank you.
The next item is Altama CPOM CIPP award. And I want to request that we defer this and have a motion to defer until our facilities meeting of next November 20th.
I move to defer this item until the next.
There's a motion.
Second.
There's a motion and second. All in favor? Motion carries 6-0. Next thing is executive director contract. Mr. Dominic. Executive director contract?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Need a motion? You need a motion, sir?
Yeah, I need a motion.
Yeah, I make a motion that to authorize the chairman to enter into a contract with Mr. Burroughs as our executive director.
Second.
Any questions? Motion second. All in favor indicate by right. Motion carries 6-0. Congratulations, Andrew.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that and the confidence the commissioners.
I want to take this time to thank, first off, Teamwork Services for their assistance in advertising for this position, and also working with the different people who applied for the position, and also setting up the interview process that we had. And I also want to thank our Human Resources Committee for their work conducting the telephone interviews, and then the entire commission for the way we conducted the interviews of the three finalists for this position. We had three excellent candidates, and we've got an excellent executive director that we're looking forward to working with, and we're looking forward to seeing this JWSC really move forward and prosper under his leadership. So I hope everybody will support him. I think the staff has shown their support for him, everybody I've talked to, and we really appreciate what he's done in the interim, and we know we've got great things to look forward to in the future.
Thank you, sir.
The next thing we'll move to discussion is a banking RFP update. Andrew Burrs.
Yes, sir. As the commissioner is aware, we've been out going for banking services. We received the RFPs Tuesday. We have received five proposals. Now, we had three different services that we went out for. That's banking services, merchant services, and investment services. We had five total proposals, but not everyone submitted for all three services. So we received three submissions for banking services, four submissions for merchant services, and two submissions for investment services. We have interviews scheduled with the five proposers on the 13th and 14th. Coming up, we'll have our scoring committee that will be there, and there'll be an hour-long interview, and then we hope to go through that process and make a recommendation prior to the end of the year.
Okay. I have one request, and that is that the scoring team include current services and the cost therein, such that we don't have to award the contract, but it needs to be clear that we need to make a change because we get a better deal if that's what we choose to do.
Yes, sir. That is included in the scoring criteria that was posted. We have a very detailed criteria for this, knowing that this is a large decision.
Those will be reviewed at finance before?
Yes,
going to the full.
Absolutely.
Will it be reviewed at the upcoming finance?
It's unlikely they'll be reviewed at probably in December.
Any other questions? Next item is revised audit report.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Obviously, I am not Mr. Donaghy. He is taking some well-deserved time off, so I'm sitting in his chair today. But just came to share with you that you may remember at last month's meeting, Mr. Donaghy presented the auditor's report, and there was a question that was raised concerning the variance between some figures that were shown for the salaries, wages, and overtime versus what the actuary had termed covered payroll. Mr. Donaghy explained at that meeting that the variance had resulted from the actuary using calendar year figures versus our budget and our audit being for fiscal year data. So that's why there was a variance between the two figures. At that meeting, the commission did request that the finance team coordinate with the audit team to revise that management's discussion and analysis portion to include a note that clarified that. That certainly occurred. We did get a revised report from the auditors. That revision did not change the auditor's opinion on that particular report. But that updated package now has been distributed to the City of Brunswick, Glynn County, the Georgia Department of Community Affairs, the Municipal Securities Rulemaking Board, as well as the Georgia Department of Audits and Accounts to fulfill our reporting requirements to those agencies. And those are all the remarks I have, unless there are questions from the Commission.
Any questions? Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Executive Director's update.
Yes, sir. We have the Ridgewood Water Production Facility pre-bid scheduled for next Wednesday. That'll be Wednesday afternoon, I believe. So hopefully we're going to get a lot of participation there. It is mandatory, so we'll know what our bidder pool is after next week.
two customer service issues that we are proud to report. We have been testing both paperless billing and recurring payments for the last couple of months with a group of customers, and we're happy to say that that has went very well, and we are now able to offer that to any customer that so chooses. So that's paperless billing and recurring payments if you would like that auto-drafted out of your account. If you have any questions or would like to take part in that, customer service will be happy to set you up with that. So that was a particular issue brought up at one of our town hall meetings, so happy to say that we got that corrected. We have the annual State of the County Luncheon coming up on the 20th. I've emailed all of you, and most of you have responded that you would like to attend, so just want to remind you of that. The grand jury process is wrapping up, and the announcement for our position will be on the 20th as well. And then the last thing I've got, I would like to congratulate one of our commissioners. Commissioner Stevens has been named the Vice President for Support Services at the hospital, so I'd like to congratulate him on that tremendous accomplishment.
Changes.
The ordinance changes, we've passed them all here. They're still under review by the city and the county. I spoke with the city and county attorneys this week, trying to nudge them in the right direction. So they are working on it.
When a bid's going to be received on the Ridgewood well?
Ridgewood, the bids are due the 5th, that's the first week of December. We added a little extra time in there because of the Thanksgiving holiday.
So when did you say December?
December 5th.
Okay. Okay. I don't have a further update. I'm just real pleased we've gone through the process and we have a fine executive director. We do need to go into executive session for property and litigation. Do I hear a motion to go into executive session again?
So moved.
Second.
Motion second. All in favor? Motion carries. All in favor indicate by raising your right hand. Motion carries. Motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor? Meeting's adjourned.
Thank you.
I said adjourn.